So I'm going to discuss about the Baring Bank case. So let me summarize the case study. The Baring Bank was founded in the year 1762. It was a United Kingdom institution with worldwide reach. And in the year 1989, Nick Leeson, an employee, was hired at Baring. He was highly talented, so he was quickly promoted to the trading floor and he was appointed as a manager in the Singapore office. Leeson was an aggressive trader. He used to make profit in speculative trading. That means he was focused more on speculative trading. And in the year 1992, a new Baring employee suffered a small loss under the supervision of Leeson. And Leeson did not wish to lose his reputation. So he hid the losses in an error account. He created a suspense account known as error account and he hid the loss in that account. He attempted to make back the losses through speculative trading, but this led to even higher losses, which again hidden in the same account. Then Leeson took out a short-term highly levered bet on Nike index in Japan. And at the same time, a severe earthquake in Kobe, Japan sent the index plummeting and his loss was so huge that he could no longer hide it. And Baring's, a 233-year-old bank, collapsed overnight and was bought by ING. And the Leeson was Germany and extradited to Singapore. This is the case study all about. Baring's was a 233-year-old well-established bank and Nick Leeson was appointed as a manager in the Singapore office. He was mainly concentrated on the speculative trading and he made a huge amount of profit in this area. And he, because of his unauthorized derivative speculation, he also made a huge amount of loss to the bank. So there are some questions regarding the case study. So let's check out. First question, what was the Nick Leeson strategies to earn trading profit on derivatives? I have already mentioned that the Nick Leeson was mainly concentrated on the speculative trading. He used to make profit in the particular area, that means speculative trading. He was mainly dealt with the arbitrage, low trade arbitrage. And he also betted that he had done a bet that the Nike index in Japan will rise, but instead of rising, it fell down and caused him loss of 1.39 billion loss. That made a huge amount of loss. So this was the strategy which he made to compensate the error account. So let's check out the second question. What went wrong that caused his strategies to fail? So Nick Leeson had a strategy that he could earn a huge amount of profit from the Nick Index Japan. Due to the severe earthquake in Japan created a continuous falling of index. But he believed that one day there will be a rise in the index. So he continued to bet that it would rise in the upcoming future. But the opposite had happened. So these went wrong that caused his strategies to fail. And the third question is that why did Nick Leeson establish a bogus error account when a legitimate already existed? Nick Leeson had established a bogus error account in order to conceal his unauthorized trading activities because he don't want to lose his reputation. That's why he created a bogus error account. And this account was known to the authorities, but this account has been known as a customer account, not as an error account. And on the other hand, CMEX thought that the bogus error account, the mentioned number, the account number has been mentioned, was a legitimate customer account rather than a proprietary Baring account. And the fourth question is about why did Baring's and auditors not discover that error account was used by Leeson for unauthorized trading? As we all know that in every organization there will be internal audit and an external audit. In the Barings Bank, the auditors were failed to identify the crime or the fraud committed by the Leeson. It was their mistake. They never conducted a audit in a proper way. So Leeson engaged in unauthorized trading as well as a fraud. There were no clearly laid down reporting line with regards to Leeson. But in August 1994, James Baker completed an internal audit for the Singapore office. He made several recommendations that he could have altered Barings executives to the potential for unauthorized trading. None of these had been accepted upon the time of bank collapse. And the fifth question is about suggest regulatory and management that might prevent a future debacle of the type that bankrupted Barings. So here we want to give solution or suggestions to the future in order to avoid the bank corruption. So first solution is that the management team have a duty to understand. They should understand the what the business is all about and how they can manage the business. They should understand that. And the responsibility authority should be clearly established and communicated to the people. And relevant internal controls, including the risk management, also has to be established. And next comes the clear segregation of duties is fundamental to every field or every business. And top management and the audit committee have to ensure that significant weakness and identify them by internal audit or otherwise should solve quickly. So before concluding, let's check what are the major three reasons behind the collapse of Barings Bank. The first reason is that one rogue trader, that is Nick Leeson, who made a big mistake which led to the collapse of bank. And next, second reason is that an unlikely series of events in the market. The market, we know that the market is fluctuating, and these fluctuations also created loss to the bank. And incompetent management. The management was not properly managed, and the auditing has not done perfectly. So these also created a loss to the bank. These are the major reasons which created the loss of or the collapse of the 233-year-old Barings Bank. Thank you.